Hello everyone, in this video you have one triangle, its length is given 4, here is given 8, and length of the AD is given 4 root 7, and these two angles are given as equal. The question is, what is the area of the triangle ABC? Okay. First of all, if you draw a parallel line to line AB like this, let's call here point K. If you focus on triangle DKC, this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Because they have same angles. So triangle DKC and triangle BAC are similar. Therefore, if there's a 2A opposite side of the 4, opposite side of the 8 here must be equal 4A, right? Why? Because we know that ratio of these two sides must be equal ratio of these two sides. Then let's call these two equal angles alpha. So here must be equal alpha, right? Because of parallel. Next step, if you focus on triangle AKD, notice that this triangle has same base angles. That means triangle AKD is an isosceles triangle. So the length of the AK must be equal the length of the DK. Therefore, this length is also 2A, right? So let's call here M. You know that ratio of 2A over M must be equal ratio of 8 over 12, right? If we simplify the expression, so M is going to be 3A. Let's write here, M equal 3A, right? Let's create here. You notice that we have an angle bisector line here, right? So according to angle bisector theorem, the square of the length of AD is equal to product of these two sides, 3A times 6A minus product of these two parts. Right? Therefore, 16 times 7 equal 18A squared minus 32. So 112 plus 32 equal 18A squared. That means A squared equal 144 over 18. Let's square root both sides of the equation. A is equal to 12 over 3 root 2. That means A is going to be 2 root 2. Right? Okay. Let's write here 3A equal 6 root 2 and 2A equal 4 root 2. 4A equal 8 root 2 and 2a equal 4 root 2. Right. After that, if you focus on triangle AKD, this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So if you draw a perpendicular line onto the base will be divided into two equal parts. Right? After that, this length I want to represent with y. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of y, right? So y squared plus 2 root 7 whole squared equal 4 root 2 whole squared. Therefore, y squared plus 28 equal 32. That means y squared equal 4. So y is going to be 2 units. That's right here. Y equal 2. Okay. After this, we can find the area using either the sine formula, the Heron's formula, or other methods. But I want to use the sine formula. Okay, let's create here. According to sine formula, the area of the triangle ABC is equal to this length, 6 root 2 times this length, 12 root 2 over 2 times sine 2 alpha, right? You know that sine 2 alpha equal 2 times sine alpha times cosine alpha, so equal 2 times sine alpha equal 2 over 4 root 2, right? Let's plug in times cosine alpha equal 2 root 7 over 4 root 2. Therefore, sine 2 alpha equal, if you simplify the expression, so sine 2 alpha equal root 7 over 4. If you plug in this value to the equation, sine 2 alpha equal root 7 over 4, if we simplify, that means the area of the triangle ABC is going to be 18 root 7 units squared. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.